Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. My name is Plummy, and in this episode of Radio K, in contrast to the last episode in which I reacted to a bunch of girl group songs, in this one I'm gonna be reacting to a bunch of boy group songs. Those being Ace's favorite boys, otherwise known as Goblin, I believe. Super Junior, D&E, and their song BAD, or B-A-D. SuperM's Tiger Inside, and Wonho's debut song Open Mind. There are a few things I want to say about these songs. First of all, I'm most excited about Ace's favorite boys and SuperM's Tiger Inside, because those two groups kind of appeal to me, I guess, and I'm curious whether Tiger Inside specifically is going to be better than the other songs that I reacted to, which I forgot the name of. For Super Junior, D&E, I'm curious to see how the song is going to sound, because I think the only song I know from D&E is the song Can You Feel It? I think that's what its name is. Which is that song which goes Choki 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 Wa Choa Choki Choki Wa Wa. That's the only thing, the only song of theirs that I know. And I'm curious how it's going to be in comparison to that one, because I love that one. It's catchy and viral as hell, and it became viral. And for Wonho, I'm curious to see how his debut song going to sound like, because I really love Losing You. But I'm curious what he is going to go for with a solid Korean debut. So yeah, without further ado, let's just jump into it, starting off with my favorite and most interested song out of these four, Ace's favorite boys, in 3, 2, 1. I've been waiting for Ace to come back. I can't wait to listen to the song. I love Undercover, I love Savage. I'm hoping that I'm gonna love this one as well. Turn me up so they can hear this. Louder. Your favorite boys are back. Hell yeah! Okay, something like this. Welcome to the jungle. Got a boat set, track, go. Deeper to the upper. Okay, this is a very unusual beginning of a song, that's for sure. Okay, this one definitely sounds different, or at least in terms of structure, it's different, and I like that. And this guy's eyes are so mesmerizing. Man, this song is so all over the place. I love it. I definitely need a second listen of it though, because currently it's going in so many different directions and I just don't know how to feel. I love how maximalistic it is though. It's doing so much. Like, it's so overproduced, but in a good way. I love it. And somehow it seems like it's harder than Undercover, which is a fucking achievement. I feel like the instrumental could have been a little bit louder though. I definitely feel like it's not as an instant hit as Savage was for me. Like, that one right off the bat was different, hard-hitting, and hype as hell. This one is too, in a lot of ways. I Oh. Sorry, I got distracted. I don't know what the fuck happened here. I was like, I became so focused on the music video. I think I might have to react to this one three fucking times because the music video on its own is like so packed with stuff. So, as I was saying, Savage was a different song compared to Undercover. It wasn't as hard hitting in the instrumental, but it still went super hard and it was different and it was doing the same thing but in a different way, I would say. And that's why I like this one is going in a completely different direction, I feel like, both with the sound. I feel like the sound is not as dark for this one, and it's not as I don't know if it's rockish, because I feel like Undercover had a lot of rock influence, but Savage didn't really. But it's not as that kind, it's not that kind of dark vibe. I'm not really getting that kind of dark vibe for this one. From this one, I'm getting, I don't even know how to describe this vibe, but there's so much, there's so much happening. Like, I don't even know where to begin. So let's just get into it one more time, and I'm just gonna point out stuff that I can think of as we go along. So for this one, I'm gonna be focused, for this second reaction, I'm gonna be focusing on the music video. Then we're gonna check it out one more time, and I'm gonna focus on the song again. Because for this one, I feel like you need like half a dozen listens before you can actually grasp what's happening with the song. So let's get into it again in 3, 2, 1. It definitely is a unique song though. I can tell you that for sure.
Okay, something like this. Welcome to the jungle. Got a boat that track go. Deep in the upper. Don't give a hell, let's go. I'm a touch girl. Come on, dream.
I feel like there's like 5 or 10 different songs slapped into this one. And it's kind of the same thing for the music video. There's so much happening, so much different things happening. I love how both the song and the music video are so in your face and just overwhelming you all the time. I love that. Honestly, Ace should be so much more popular. I love how this song definitely goes as hard as Undercover, if not more, but it goes in a different way. It's not as dark, it's actually much brighter. Okay, I'm loving this. This is just overwhelming my freaking senses. I don't even know what to talk about. I'm also loving the choreo, like, what the hell? This is way too much for me to process. I love this, honestly. Like, I love the dark vibe that they were going for in Undercover and Savage, but I'm also loving how much shit they're shoving in this one and shoving in your face, both in the instrumental and the music video. I love that. This is a really ambitious song. Also, this kind of comes a little bit out of nowhere, but I kind of like it. I'm definitely curious what do people think about this. Oh my god, I love the choreo, I love how it goes with the song. It goes so good, like, I don't know how to describe this song and music video, like, I'm speechless. I'm genuinely speechless after this. Holy shit, like, I don't even know what to say, I love this. I guess let's get into it one more time, and I'm gonna try to say as much as I can, but I'm just speechless. I don't know what to say about this. It's just so good. The only thing that I don't necessarily don't like it, but I definitely would have preferred if it still was a darker vibe. But still, despite being more of a brighter one, it still goes so damn hard and it's so good. Yeah, let's get into it one more final time in 3, 2, 1. This group definitely has some of the most unique visuals that I've seen from guys. And this is a very unique song.
Okay, sounds like this.
I love how it just instantly just punches you in the face with the beat and how hard it's going. Ooh, he looks like a devil. I really wonder what people feel about this, because this is really in your face, and I feel like for some people this might be the epitome of what a lot of people call noise music. I use it as a positive term, some people use it as a negative term. It's just easy for me to use it to explain these kind of songs because other people know what it means. I love that it hits so hard. Ooh, I love the smooth choreo. It really goes well with the song. Ooh. Man, I didn't think they could go harder than Undercover, honestly. But this is so much harder. I just wish it was as dark as Undercover. But still, it's amazing. And this is a group from a small ass company. They deserve to be so much more popular than they are. They deserve to be up there with the current 4th generation top groups, with 80s, with Stray Kids, with G-Idol. I love these white coats that they're wearing. I think it might be some Korean traditional outfit, but I'm not sure. Doing this part, the core is so fucking good. Whew. Jesus, this one is really fucking draining. But I goddamn love it. It's so good. I would say it's pretty much exactly how good I expected it to be. I was hoping for another dark song because I feel like Savage and Undercover were darker songs. I wouldn't really call them dark or edgy, but I feel like it's just the kind of vibe I was getting from them was on the dark side. And we didn't really get that with this one. This one definitely feels more brighter, but it's still hard and powerful and with sick rapping, and I love it. I love it. My only complaint, as I said, is just I wish it was a dark song. I wish it was as dark as Undercover and Savage. But I still love it. And I kind of consider maybe giving it a little bit of a less than 10 out of 10 because it's not as dark. But honestly, that's a stupid thing to get hung up on for this song. So personally and objectively, I'm honestly gonna give it a 10 out of 10. This is an amazing song. I don't know if it's gonna be my favorite song of theirs because I feel like Undercover and Savage just appeal to me more because I prefer darker and edgier stuff in music and in general. And this one is not really dark or edgy, so that kind of drags it down a little bit, as I said. But I still admire what they did production-wise with this song. It's so jam-packed with instrumentals and vocals and rapping, and in the music video there's so much stuff happening in the choreo, and like it's a visual and it's a sensuary, is that a word? It's a sensuary overload for your eyes and ears, and I love it. Like, it's such a maximalistic kind of song that tries to shove as much things it can into it, and I love that, and I admire that they went for that. I just wish the vibe was darker, but it's still, it's an amazing song. And I love it, and I'll definitely be listening to it. So now let's get into the next song of this video, that being Super Junior, D&E's B.A.D. in 3, 2, 1. Yeah, I don't really know what to expect, so I guess we'll see. Wait, he has a very interesting voice. It's so cool that Super Junior, for how old the group is, it's still going and they're still releasing music. I love the groups that I enjoy today, like Stray Kids and ATS, can continue releasing music that far in the future. Okay, it's actually pretty decent. I like the instrumental. Wait, are there other members? Oh no, wait, I'm confusing this guy with somebody else. Okay, the rest of the song was kind of decent, but this part here is so good. bad. Okay, for that part here at the end, I'm gonna be listening to the song again. Because the rest of the song, it was good, but nothing special, but that part really popped off. I'm also really liking the choreo, it's pretty cool. It's pretty catchy choreo, for a lack of a better term. I don't really know how otherwise to explain it, but it's just a catchy choreo to watch. I don't know. Yeah, let's get into it one more time, because I surprisingly enjoyed that ending part of it, and I want to listen to it again in 3, 2, 1. And who knows, maybe I'm gonna love it more on the second listen. I'm actually not sure whether it's the same guys who released Can You Feel It? It does feel a little bit awkward that a 30 years old plus guy is singing a K-pop song. It does feel a little awkward for me watching that. I assume he's more than 30 years old. It would make sense. But I also kind of like that part. Oh yeah, on second listen, it's definitely a little more catchier. The chorus does pop off a lot though. It's just the lyrics could be a little bit catchier here. Damn it, my back. I confused this guy with one of the members of Mustangs. That's who I was going to say. That's why I was asking, were there... Yeah, this part here is so good. I wish more of the song was like this. I feel like a lot of the song, especially the chorus, is a little too empty. And I like how much is happening in this part of the song here. Especially after listening to Ace's favorite voice, like anything else just feels empty. Like even this ending part is better than the rest of the song. Okay, so this song is definitely better than I thought it was going to be, because I thought it probably, because I was expecting something similar to Can You Feel It, it probably wasn't going to live up to the hype I had for it, which wasn't that much, but I expected probably as viral and as good of a song as Can You Feel It was. And this one is kind of like that. Like, I do feel like the quality is on par with that one, but it's also a very different song because I feel like Can You Feel It was more of a softer, playful kind of song, like for fun, but this one is more harder and darker, and I definitely like that about it. But as I said, a lot of the song, especially the chorus, feels a little bit empty, and it's not necessarily too bad because I do like the instrumental a lot, and in some parts, I would say the instrumental is definitely catchier than the lyrics, for the most part. But in that ending part, it really pops off, and I really like that part. And I wish more of the song was like that, but it's not, so I'm gonna judge it based on what we have right now. And what we have, I would say, it's a solid song, but not something that is really amazing. Like, it's good, and I like it, and I will probably listen to it, but I've heard better songs for sure, and I definitely like Super Junior's Iya Iya Yo much more than this. So personally, for this one, I'm gonna give it an 8.4 out of 10, while objectively, I think I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. So yeah, let's move on to the next song of this video, that being SuperM's Tiger Inside, in 3, 2, 1. Ooh, that look. Yeah. Wait, is that Mark with a mullet? And pink hair? Damn, you look so good. Why does the song sound more playful rather than hard-hitting? I mean, maybe that's what they intended, but... Okay, I definitely like this more than the other song that they released. What was the name of it? 100? Yeah, this one's definitely better. Also, I'm sorry if the audio here is completely gone, or at least for the music video, because it might get claimed, because my reaction to 100 did get blocked, so I had to remove the audio of the song. Yeah, this one definitely is more interesting and fun to listen to. Also, this one feels a little bit more sophisticated. I don't know if it's because maybe 100 was in English while this one is in Korean. I'm actually not sure, I can't really tell the difference. But this one just feels a little bit more sophisticated. I love that. It sounds so good, I love it. Honestly, this might be my favorite SuperM song. I think it's definitely the best. Ooh, I love all this camera movement, that's so cool. Now this is a ultimate Avengers K K-pop group. Now it feels like an SM Avengers K-pop group. I love that. Because, like, Jopping wasn't bad, but some people have said the title is a little cringy, and it felt a little underwhelming at the end. Like, it wasn't bad. I listened to it quite a lot, but it did feel a little bit underwhelming. For 100, it kind of went in the same direction like Jopping. I wouldn't say it was as cringy in terms of the lyrics or the name or whatever, but it still didn't feel as high quality, really. But this one is perfect. This is definitely their best song. And I'm pretty sure this is the title track, while 100 was a single, so I guess it makes sense that this one is gonna be better, but I'm loving this one so much more. Like, it's really good. So let's get into it one more time in 3, 2, 1. Yeah, this is really catchy. That hook is so catchy. Also, Mark with pink hair and a mullet is something that I didn't know I needed. Oh yeah, I'm loving this one. And yeah, it somehow also manages to go harder than 100. Because I actually feel like 100 is a little bit rougher. This one is a little bit more polished, which is why it feels more sophisticated. But it somehow manages to go harder, and I actually like that. I also really like the choreo. Okay, that hook is sick. The director of this music video did a really good job. So did the choreographer as well. I keep forgetting that Ten is in this group as well. I feel like it's just because he doesn't have as a... How to say it? I feel like he doesn't have as a memorable face as everybody else, or I just haven't really memorized his face as much as everybody else, because everybody else stands out so much from each other. Oh, this part here, I love the camera work here. The song sounds so good, the outfits are cool, the dancing is amazing, the camera work is awesome. I love this ending part. Like, the choreo for this one is probably their best one, I would say. Like, this is a proper Avengers of K-pop kind of song. Like, this is what they should have debuted with, if you ask me. Because this is so good, and it would have delivered on the hype people had for it, or at least I had for it. But damn, like, I did not expect this to be as good. Like, for some reason, for me at least, like, SuperM just hasn't been able to really live up to the hype. Like, the songs are not bad, they definitely are the kind of songs that I enjoy, but there's just something a little underwhelming about them for Jopping and for 100 as well. But this one finally managed to live up to the hype and even surpass it. It's so good, and that hook that goes "Mia ne huragi," I love that. That's so catchy. I love it. I love it. And it and even though the hook for this song is a vocal part, the song still goes super hard. The choreo is amazing, and I love whenever in the choreo they have jumps. They have to do jumps. I think towards the end, even when the camera work is going crazy. There's one shot in which they kind of do a little jump, and I love that. It works really well with the choreo, and it looks badass, and I love that. I love it. This is amazing. The song is amazing. It's definitely their best one, the most sophisticated one, the one that feels the more complete and high quality. And because of that, I'm gonna give it a 12 out of 10. It surpassed my expectations completely. I did not expect to ever get a genuinely good song from SuperM that feels good and feels high quality, but we got one, I guess. But damn, this is good. I'm pretty sure everybody else is gonna love this song as well. Like, I think this is exactly what people have been waiting for to get from SuperM, because what they've released so far wasn't bad, but this is amazing. It's good. It's really good. I love that. And yeah, objectively, again, also, I'm going to give it a 12 out of 10. I think that was kind of self-explanatory, but I almost forgot to say it. But yeah, this was amazing. I'm pretty sure this might be an album. So if it is an album or an EP or a mini album, I am going to check out the B-sides eventually. As long as the video doesn't get blocked by some American music company, because it tends to happen with American releases, and I'm not sure whether SuperM's releases are considered American or Korean ones. So yeah, I don't even know if I had to edit out the audio for these songs from this video. You'll probably know by the time you're watching this video, but there's a possibility that I might have had to remove it because it got blocked by UGM, I think it's called. But yeah, I really enjoyed this, and I'll definitely be listening to this one. So now let's get into the last song of this video, that being Wonho's Open Mind. And I'm really curious because I don't really know what to expect from this. I wonder if it's gonna go with a harder sound similar to Monster X, or whether he's going to go with something like what Losing You was. Either way, I think I'm gonna enjoy it, but I just hope it's not a ballad. That's my only worry. But yeah, we're gonna find out by getting into it in 3, 2, 1. Okay, it's definitely not gonna be a ballad. Showing his absent muscles, I see. Not complaining. But I'm personally not into that. But I think most people will love it. He really is ripped though. Damn. It's so weird seeing such a muscular guy be a K-pop idol though. Like, he's basically exploding out of every top that he's wearing. But because of that, he does have a unique vibe going for him.
I want the same thing. 상상하지 마. 언젠 다를 테니까. 오늘 밤에.
And yeah, the song is kind of what I ultimately knew that it was going to be. Like, I wanted it to be something similar to Monster X's music. Which is not really, but it's also not too far off, I would say. I was worried that it probably was going to be a ballad, which is not, so I'm glad about that. But the end product, while not bad, I feel like it's a little bit generic. Like, this is pretty much what most solo releases from ex-members of groups tend to sound like, I feel. Like, in some ways, it reminds me of the releases by the ex-members of B.A.P. I feel like it's not too far off. And yeah, for this one, I'm actually not gonna react to it a second time because it just, there's not much going for it that I haven't really seen already. I said it. It feels a little bit too generic. Like, the song is not bad and it's certainly listenable, but I was hoping for something maybe a little bit more interesting. Like, even Losing You wasn't what I would have wanted to get from him, but I love it because it was an emotional song that was basically talking about him leaving Monster X, if you didn't get that. And I really love that song, and if we got something like that again, I would have complained. And I'm not complaining by what we've got, actually. I enjoy it, and it's fast and energetic, but I don't know. As I said, it just feels a little bit generic, in my opinion. It's not bad, but it could have been better. But at least one unique thing going for him is how fucking ripped he is. Like, he's crazy ripped, even by ripped K-pop idol standards. Because there are a bunch of them. Like, he's ripped. Like, he's ripped. So yeah, I think personally for the song, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10, a solid 8. Because I enjoyed listening to it, and I probably wouldn't mind listening to it again, but it's not really that unique, and I feel like in K-pop, that's kind of what I look for nowadays. And this one is just a little bit generic. Still, I've listened to even much more generic songs, and it's still better than most generic sounding songs, but it's still generic. It's definitely leaning towards the generic side of things. While objectively, honestly, I think I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10. I think most people are gonna enjoy this. They're not picky like me. So I think most people are gonna be fine with the release of this. That it's not super unique or super emotional. That it's pretty much your average K-pop song. And at the end of the day, the song really doesn't really have anything bad about it. Like, for what it is, even though it's generic, it's still pretty much perfectly made. Like, there wasn't a moment in the song where I was like, oh, this is not catchy, oh, this is boring, oh, this is annoying. No, it's a pretty good song for what it is. It's just what it is, it's a little bit too generic for my tastes. So yeah, this video actually ended up being pretty fun. Like, we got at least two songs that I really like and two songs that I like a decent amount. So combine this video with the last one, and I have quite a few songs to listen to for the next few days. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe. Also, check out the link in the description to my Twitter if you want to follow me there, and to my Wattpad, where I post my stories, because in addition to doing all these videos on my channel, I'm also a writer. And if you end up enjoying my stories, or simply enjoy my videos, you can head over to Patreon, where you can pledge your support and help keep the channel going and help support me so I can keep writing the stories you enjoy. But if you don't want to support me monetarily, that is completely fine. I don't want to guilt trip you into helping me out or beg you to help me out. You can still help me out in other ways, like liking this video, subscribing, and especially sharing this video with somebody who you think might enjoy it. And I think that's pretty much it for this video, so hopefully I'm gonna see you in the next one. Bye!